But look how God's sun is shining both outside and in our hearts on today. And now let us praise God for where all our blessings flow.
Looks like way back in my early youth. But this is a song that's reflected. Once again, God is us a few of your children who have first of all come to say thank you. God, we thank you through this week's journey, oh God, that you have brought us here and you brought us through the sadness and through the sorrow. You brought us through death. You brought us through pain. You brought us this far. So here we are, God, to give ourselves away. We come laying it all at your feet so we may hear from you. God, we ask that you just come in the room. Have your way in this place. Touch us from the crown of our head to the soles of our feet. Touch our pastor, oh God, that she may stand to preach your uncompromising word. God, we ask that you feed us till we want no more. And then that you give us the living water that will never run dry. So have your way. Have your way. Do what you do, God, and be God alone. God, we thank you. There's just nothing else we want to do but give you all the honor, the glory, and the praise. Through it all, God, we are
God with the voice of honor. And now I'm going to read from John chapter 14, which is triumphant, because Jesus is on the last mile of the way. And he is almost there, and he fixed it so that he fixed what was broken. He healed breaches. He cast the devil out of the room so he can get on with his friends here, the 11. So when you get home today, I hope that you will bless yourself by reading chapter 14, John 14, all the way to chapter 17. And I guarantee you, it's going to dispel darkness, it's going to encourage your heart, and as you read, you will feel it in your very person. I do. So this begins, and he's in the upper room. This is Passover. And the boys are kind of sad, but look what Jesus says. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms or mansions. If it weren't so, I would have told you. He would have said, if I had every room, I would have told you I'd have. But that's not true. He's making rooms for each one of us. You. So that when we up here with him, he's got the house already. All we got to do is sit down and rest a little while. And I go and prepare a place for you. I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way and the place where I'm going. Now check this out. Thomas, forever doubting, always thinking, look like the worst of everything. Lord, we don't know where you're going, or how can we know the way? Big question to him. Jesus answered, and put this to memory in your very heart. Jesus said, I am the way, and the what? Truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. He's fixing everything so that we have a path to glory. If you really knew me, you would know my Father as well. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. I believe I just saw Darius come in. Come into the sanctuary, Darius. We can just celebrate the life of his grandmother. Darius, you can come this way. We've been standing collectively together praying for him and his family. He wrote a special reading for his grandmother for the celebration of life. And I wanted to share that with us on today. I think it's so appropriate. So we pour into generations that come after us. It's what lives on forever. And I thank him for his bravery and his boldness to share that word with us on today. Amen.
Amen.
Instead of I think she met for me to call that freeway instead of struggling through endless rivers awaiting the shore. But I ever really proved that message to me the time I spent with her. She'd always tell me that she didn't grow 66 for nothing, not even used to that. She was such a hard worker and very hardly took the short, the easy way out since I've been born. Yaya was such an amazing and outgoing person, and a blessing sent straight from God. It was all for the spirit passed on, but I know God has her in his arms, along with all the loved ones she's seen pass in her lifetime. Although the pain is here going out, she got so much of a better place, with her pain not taken away, and her sorrows for God. I believe she truly loves seeing the heaven's gates, and I believe that she truly will appreciate her time with God and everyone else she loves again.
worship and our love, it is a blessing to you. So we want you all both just to relax, enjoy, just worship God in spirit and in truth. Make yourself at home. And to those in the virtual space who are worshiping with us, we are thankful for your presence. We want to serenade you in St. John's style, just to welcome you into our worship. So we can all stand and greet one another and greet our visitors. Thank you.
That he wanted to
to God? Did you talk to God? Did you pray to God? Did you seek God's advice? Did you ask God for God's wisdom and discernment? Every day that we are living, we're drawing closer to dying. Think about that for a moment. Every day that you are living, you are drawing closer to dying. Help me was a competition. He thought his friend was going to ask his mom to marry, so he beat him to the punchline. It was all about winning. When I went to that celebration of life, it was more quiet than I ever had seen before in life. And when it was time for family members and friends to make comments, the preacher called four times, and nobody got up at all. No one got up to say a word about him. His legacy was what? Win. At all costs. And then when the preacher got up to preach the eulogy, my friend said, his mom said, "Baby, I need to look in my casket and see if that's your dad." They said so many nice things about him. We must keep our mind and our spirits focused on God. We must allow God to lead us and to guide us. We should not be focused on winning, but doing the will of God. Allow God to direct us and to keep us in all our ways. Matthew 6:9-21 says, "Do not store up for yourself treasures on earth, where moths and vermin do destroy, where thieves break through and steal. But store up for yourself treasures in heaven, where moths and vermin do not destroy, where thieves do not break through and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." Where is your treasure, church family? Is your treasure in winning or doing the will of our Father? Where is your treasure, church family? The only way we can truly win is by being in the will of God. One of the theologians says this real wealth is obtained by investing in treasures in heaven. Your wealth is in your prayer life. Your wealth is in how you study your Bible. Your wealth is how you talk to God and you listen to God. Your wealth is in the kindness that you show to others. Your wealth is in how you treat your enemies. Your wealth is in how you endure insults and persecutions. When it all comes to an end, the greatest reward any follower of Jesus Christ can have is seeing God face to face. And Him saying to us, "Well done. Well done, my good and faithful servant." Church family, what will your legacy be to your children and grandchildren? What will your legacy be to your church family? What will your legacy be to your community? Jesus left us a legacy of love, peace, drawing individuals together. What is your legacy? Jesus left us a legacy of teaching and transforming, doing it God's way. What is your legacy? How are you leading your life, both publicly and privately? Your children and your grandchildren, they're looking at the sermon that you're preaching and how you live your life. How you treat those who are kind to you, but even how you treat those who are mean. What is your legacy? What will people say about you when you leave this earth? What are you giving this world that will live on for an eternity? Are you building up the body of Christ? Are you literally just trying to win? Jesus gave his life. For you, you and me, he came because he loved us so much. He was willing to lay down his life for us. Leaving us a legacy. What legacy are you leaving behind? You know, your past is not in line with what God wants. You serve a God of a what?
Second chance.
Today's a new day. You can never do things differently. Just because you start wrong doesn't mean you have to keep being wrong. You can't let God turn it around for you. While there is breath in your body, so we can stand all over the sanctuary. As we invite individuals to accept Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. If there is one here today who wants to give your life to Christ, now is the time. But we want to pray now just for a moment for our dear sister who is having a medical emergency right now. Let us close our eyes and extend our spirits to heaven. Lord, we just pray now in the name of Jesus. Touch now, God, from the top of her head to the bottom of her feet, God. She was one of the first people here this morning, God, coming to worship you, God. Lord, we pray for healing. Touch now the paramedics, oh God. And thank you for our nursing team here, oh God, that they will make a lot of decisions. Do what only you can do, God. Touch now. Touch your heart, God. Touch your spirit, God. We know you to be a healer of all things work. And we just claim victory in Jesus' name. Done in worship leads up to this very
Thank you.
come with thee.
Jazz Part 2.
We'll be giving you more information as we go, but we will start accepting ticket orders next Sunday. So you can do cash out, Shelby Nets, cash, we'll have some of the members out from the community. After church on Sunday, you want to pay my check, cash, whatever. But the bottom line is, go tell everybody, your family, your friends, because we had a great time. And we want to double what we gave last year. Thank you.
Let's give our praise for Mandate 2024. Amen. We are excited. We heard that the young people in middle school and high schools are already with winning experience. We'll have sharing our stories in the sanctuary as we get to know members of the congregation. And then tonight at 7 p.m., Chef Sunny, if you could stand and wave your hand. Amen. Don't wait to praise God. Praise Him.